Hello, welcome to Empress Moon Tarot 777. My name is Kimmy and I'm very happy to have you here at my channel today. This is going to be for the sign of Pisces, Sun, Moon, and Rising signs. The sign of Pisces for October 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. I hope that you're all doing well. Please keep in mind this is a general reading. It will not resonate with everyone. That is perfectly fine. Take what does and leave what doesn't. All right, Pisces. I'm going to do a 5-card spread for the 3 days. Please keep in mind the energy can extend beyond that time. And if you are ever drawn back to this reading at a later date, it could be your reading then, if you find it resonates. One additional announcement. Please be sure to click that subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the like, comment, and share. All right. Cross watchers, you're welcome here too. If you are a cross watcher, please keep in mind this can go vice versa. Feel free to swap our characters at any time. All right, Pisces, Sun, Moon, and Rising signs, please. Dream team for the sign of Pisces. Ooh, I got 4 of our cards already. We've got the Fool. We have the 2 of Cups. We have the Death card. We have the Hierophant. And we have the Knight of Swords. This is all surrounding a situation and that is going to make you very, very happy. Ooh, lovely. Pisces, look at that. Look at that. This is what's going on in your headspace, Pisces. It's what's going on in your headspace. There's a particular person whom you love very, very dearly. We have love cards here out on our spread. And this came out in your headspace. So this is somebody that you've come to know and love over a long period of time with our 10 of Cups. This is somebody that you may be in a long-term relationship with, or this could be somebody who you desire to be in a long-term relationship with. Somebody that you've known for quite a while. Could be somebody who's family as well. With the Page of Pentacles, you may be wanting to express an apology or hoping that somebody comes towards you. You may also be wanting to offer something. It could be a peace offering. It just could simply be a desire to start fresh with this person. Especially if you're currently in a long-term relationship, I do see that there has been some potential struggles in the past. Now, the overall energy for our spread is the 9 of Cups. It's how are you going to obtain your wish fulfillment? Is the wish fulfillment coming towards you? What is moving in your life right now, Pisces? So at the center of our spread, Pisces, we have the Fool. This is you having a desire for a brand new beginning. A desire for a brand new beginning with somebody that you care very deeply for. This could be a new beginning if you're in a long-term relationship. It could be a new beginning, like a fresh start, where you'd like to renew the love that the two of you have together. If you are currently single, this could be that you're wanting a fresh start with somebody else, or you're wanting to start over with somebody that you've been dealing with. The base of your spread, we have the 2 of Cups. This is entirely what this reading is surrounding. A very deep connection, one that's emotionally fulfilling, physically fulfilling, spiritually fulfilling. Very, very deep bond between you and another person. Now, although we have a female and a male on the card, this could be, you know, a same-sex relationship as well. It could be 2 women, 2 men, or a man and a woman. Does not matter. Sometimes this is soulmate, sometimes this is twin flames. They're holding hands in this particular card, which shows that strong sense of togetherness, that strong bond. Well, in the recent past, Pisces, there's something that you have to let go of, or you have recently let go of, in order to have this new beginning. Something that may have been mentally plaguing you, may have been very difficult, but it's time to let it go in order to move forward in peace. Now, crowning you, we have the Hierophant. There's a strong desire here for you to either renew a connection or to move into a long-term connection with somebody. You may want to move to exclusivity if you're not in an exclusive relationship. It's possible you may want to just simply formalize the connection between the two of you. Now, in our near future, we have the Knight of Swords. Somebody's going to be rushing in to express this desire for a new beginning. Now, our Knight of Swords looks like they're attacking, but I'm not feeling an attacking energy. I don't feel a negative energy here. This looks like this person is just wanting to rush in rapidly to communicate. However, they may be a little bit defensive because of whatever happened here in the past. They may be feeling like they're going to be coming in and be met with some difficulties from you as a result of their forward movement, but they are going to be coming in to communicate with you. Now, Pisces, for those of you that are going to be joining me for the extended, we are going to look into this much deeper, try to see if we can figure out a little bit more about what's going to be said by this person, perhaps who this person is. And we're also going to take a little bit more of a look and see what was going on there in the past. Let me pull your romance angels. Getting to know each other. So it says, as you reveal your innermost selves, your bond deepens. It's very possible that in the effort or in the movement towards having a new beginning, since this is somebody that you've already known for quite some time, that with this card, it expresses that you are going to be moving towards one another again, communicating in a way that strengthens your bond. Absolutely beautiful. Pisces, if this is where we part ways, I hope you have a wonderful day until your next reading. For those of you that are going to be joining me over on Vimeo for the extended, there is a link down below. And I will see you over there. Please be sure to click subscribe. Also hit the like button while you're here. Comment down below how this resonated with you. And I shall see you again soon. Bye-bye.